Alhamdulillah. نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، فقد ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذه الآية: واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in his verse, Fear Allah, the one you all request each other's rights from. Wal arham, ay ittaqullah wa taqu al arham. Fear Allah and fear and have God for family ties. Min la taqta'uha, meaning don't break your family ties. Inna allaha kana alaykum raqiba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over you. Wa sayas'aluka ya abdallah fil qati'ah. Na'am ya ibadullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you and question you about breaking your family ties. Ikhwati fillah, illam anna silat ar-rahim wajibatun ala kulli muslimin wa muslimah. Keeping and preserving and protecting your family ties, something as obligatory on every Muslim man and every Muslim woman. نعم يا عباد الله وإن صلة الرحم تؤدى بالإحسان. صلة الرحم, preserving the family ties, is fulfilled by doing good. وتكون ذلك في درجات بعضها فوق بعض, and that's in levels and degrees. Some of them are higher than others. أدناها أدناها يا إخوتي في الله ترك المهاجرة وذلك بالكلام والسلام. ولا ينبغي للعبد أن يكتفي بذلك وهو قادر على أحسن منه. The least درجه, or the least level of keeping family ties, is leaving off abandoning one another, and that is by speaking to one another and giving one another the salams. And that is the least level, and it is not suitable that the believer who believes in Allah on the last day, that he be sufficed with that, if he's able to do more than that. وَإِلَّا فِإِكْوَتِي فِي اللَّهِ فَإِنَّا صِلَةَ الرَّحَمِ تُعَدَّى بِالْإِحْسَانِ. Verily, keeping the family ties is fulfilled by all acts of goodness. وَذَلِكَ بِالْمَالِ, and that is by money. وذلك بالخدمة, and that is by helping and helping one another out when they're in need. وذلك بالزيارة, and that is by visiting. وذلك بالصبر على العذاب, and that is by being patient on annoyance. وذلك بالمسامحة, and that is by forgiving one another. نعم يا عباد الله وما أحوجنا في هذه الآونة الأخيرة إلى أن نتسامح لما قطعت فينا من الأرحام. Forgiving one another is a major part of preserving family ties. And we are in dire need to protect our family ties by forgiving one another. نعم يا إخوتي في الله. إن الله سبحانه وتعالى
أمر الأمم السابقة بصلة الرحم وأخذ منهم الميثاق على الإحسان إلى ذوي القربى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ordered and commanded the previous nations were protecting family ties, and He took from them a strong covenant and contract that they would be good to their family members. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَهُ وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَذِي الْقُرْبَى وَذِي الْقُرْبَى نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ وَإِذْ مَنَ اللَّهُ He took a covenant from the children of Israel, from the previous nations, that they don't worship anything other than Allah. And that to their parents, that they're kind and they're dutiful, and to their relatives. And to their relatives, na'am ya ibadallah, ya'lam ya abdallah, anna awwala ma da'a ilayhi nabiyuna Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, huwa silatul rahim. The first thing, from the first things that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called to was preserving family ties. كما جاء في صحيح مسلم من حديث عمرو بن عبسة رضي الله عنه قال كنت وأنا في الجاهلية أظن الناس على الضلالة. When I was in a time of ignorance before Islam, I saw that people were astray. وليسوا على شيء, and they not upon anything. وكانوا يعبدون الأوثان, they used to worship statues. فسمعت برجل بمكة يخبر أخبارا. I heard about a man that was in Mecca. He was telling information from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فقعدت على راحلتي فقدمت عليه. I got on my riding animal and I came to him. فإذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مستخفيا جراء عليه قومه. I ran into the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was hiding and his people were dominant on top of him. فتلطفت حتى دخلت عليه بمكة. I discreetly and secretly went until I entered upon him in Mecca. فقلت ما أنت. I said to him, what are you? قال أنا نبي. He said, I'm a prophet. قلت وما نبي. I said to him, what is a prophet? قال أرسلني الله. He said, Allah sent me. قلت بأي شيء أرسلك. I said to him, well, what thing did he send you with? فقال صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أرسلني بصلة الأرحام وكسر الأوثان وأن يوحد الله ولا يشرك به شيء من أول الإسلام. نعم يا عباد الله. He said, I was sent with keeping family ties. This is the first thing that he mentioned. I was sent from Allah to preserve the family ties and to break statues, and that only Allah is worshipped, and that nothing be associated with him in ibadah. نعم يا عباد الله. صلة الأرحام يا إخوتي في الله يشمل أقاربك ويشمل أصحارك. نعم يا عباد الله. صلة الأرحام, preserving family ties, this entails your relatives and also your in-laws, that your relatives from marriage. نعم يا عباد الله. والله سبحانه وتعالى أمر هذه الأمة بهذه العبادة الجليلة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded the believers of this ummah with this high act of ibadah. فقال ربنا سبحانه وتعالى واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا وذي القربى واليتامى والمساكين. قبل اليتامى والمساكين ذوي القربى يا عبد الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, worship Allah and don't associate anything with him in worship, and be dutiful and be kindful and be kind to your parents and your relatives and the orphans and the poor. Before Allah mentioned the orphans, before he mentioned the poor, he mentioned your relatives and he mentioned your family members and those that are from your ashar, from your in-laws. Na'am ya ibadullah. وبين الله سبحانه وتعالى أن صلة الأرحام بالنفقة وبالأموال. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned that keeping the family ties is by spending your money. هذا من حقهم. This is from their right upon you. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. They ask you, what should they spend their money on? قُلْ مَا أَنْفَقْتُ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلِلْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ وَالْيَتَامَى. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. He said, that which you spend from your money is for your parents and for your relatives and for the orphans. وَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَآتِ ذَا الْقُرْبَى حَقَّهُ. Give your relatives their due rights. حَقُّهُ أَيُّسَلْ وَلَا يُقْطَعْ مَحْمَكَانْ. And you sell, wala yukta. Give your relative their due right. Wa ati dal qurba hatta. Give them their rights. They have rights over you, and their right is that their sila is protected, and that their family connection is protected, and that they are not cut off. Na'am ya ibadallah. Qala an-nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kama ja'a min hadithi Amr ibn al-As. Laysa al-wasilu bil mukafa'ah. ليس الواصل بالمكافأة ولكن الواصل إذا قطعت رحمه وصلها. هكذا يا عبد الله. واصلة, the one who keeps his family ties, he doesn't just do it if they keep it or if they could talk to him or if they don't cut him off. But keeping family ties means even if they cut you off and even if they turn their back and even if they don't talk to you, you go out of your way. You do the best you can do to preserve those family ties. نعم يا عباد الله. وجاء كذلك من حديث عمرو بن العاص عند الإمام أحمد أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله تعالى أنا الرحمن وأنا خلقت الرحم وشققت لها من اسمي فمن يصلها أصله وَمَنْ يَقْتَعُهَا أَقْتَعْهُ. يَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ إِنَ عَنْتَ وَسِلَةَ الرَّحَمِ لَا يَقْتَعُكَ اللَّهِ يَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ عَلَى عَمْرِ الْحَيِّنِ. لَا يَقْتَعُكَ اللَّهِ يَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ عَلَى عَمْرِ الدُّنْيَوِي عَلَى عَمْرِ السَّهَلِ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm ar-Rahman and I made the rahim, meaning the womb, the family ties. And I extracted the family ties from my name, meaning Ar-Rahim, it's from Ar-Rahman. Whoever keeps the family ties and joins it, I join with him. Whoever cuts it off, I cut him off. Intabih, be careful. وَحَذَا قَصَارِ فِي صِحَتِكْ وَحَذَا قَصَارِ فِي تِجَارَتِكْ وَحَذَا قَصَارِ فِي كُلِّ مَا عَنْدَ فِي بِسَبَبِ قَطَعِكْ لِلْأَرْحَامِ. Beware, that's the problem that's with you in your life, or with you in your money, and with you in your health. قَدْ قَطَعَكَ اللَّهُ. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cuts you off. انتبه يا عبد الله. فإن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما جاء عن عائشة رضي الله عنها يبين عنه واصل الرحم رفيق رحيم والذي يقطعها بخيل متكبر. The one who keeps his family ties is merciful and he's kind. And the one who cuts off his family ties is bakhil. He's cheap, he's mutakabbir, and that he's arrogant. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إنه من أعطي حظه من الرفق فقد أعطي حظه من خير الدنيا والآخرة. Whoever has been given a good portion of kindness, then he has been given a good portion of all the good in this world and the hereafter. وَسِلَةَ الرَّحَمِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ وَحُسْنُ الْجِيرَانِ يَعْمُرَانَ الدِّيَارِ. هَذَا الَّذِي يَعْمُرَ الدِّيَارِ. سِلَةَ الرَّحَمِ وَحُسْنُ الْجِيرَانِ يَعْمُرَانَ الدِّيَارِ وَيَزِيدَانِ فِي الْأَعْمَارِ. Keeping the family ties and keeping close with your neighbors, this is what keeps the houses alive and keeps the families vibrant. كم من بيت أفسدته القضيعة إلا أن الله يستر. How many families breaking off the family ties has split it up and has messed up the whole family, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shields and covers تسر الله سبحانه وتعالى السلام والعافية.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إخوتي في الله، قد مضت عشرات من السنين، بل مئات من السنين، وقد حففت الأنساب. Years, dozens of years, maybe hundreds of years has passed, and these families and these lineages have been preserved.
إلا أن تأتي أنت بقضيتك. حتى أتيت أنت بقضيتك. Until you came with your little problem. فقطعتها. قطعت ما كان محفوظا قبل أن خلقت أنت. You cut off what was protected before you even been created. نعم يا عبد الله انتبه. قطيعتك تفسد الأسرة. When you cut off family ties, it cuts off a whole lot. تفسد. تفسد زواج أختك وتفسد على إخوانك وتفسد أبناء خالك وتفسد على بنات عمتك. نعم أيها الذكي تسامه يا إخوتي في الله.
When you cut off your arham and you cut off your family members, it messes up your sister's wedding, it messes up your this situation with your brothers, and it cuts off the sons of your uncle, and it cuts off the daughters from your aunt.
نعم يا إخوتي في الله. فلذلك يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى ولا يأتر أولي الفضل منكم والسعة أن يؤتوا ذوي القربى. Nobody swear by Allah and say, wallahi, those two people have position and wealth and good position, that they're not going to give their family members. لا تفعل هذا يا إخوتي في الله. نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما جاء ابن عباس رضي الله عنه, حافظوا على أنسابكم تصلوا أرحامكم.
This is how you protect your family ties.
حافظوا أنسابكم. Protect your lineage. Protect your long years of lineage. سنوات عديدة. حافظوها. كيف؟
تصلوا أرحامكم.
Protect your family ties. ذلك بالمال وبالزيارة وبالخدمة وبالمسامحة. You protect your family ties with your money and with visiting and by humbling them out and by forgiving.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد ذلك فإنه لا بعد بالرحم إذا قربت وإن كانت بعيدة
ولا قرب بها إذا بعدت وإن كانت قريبة. There's no distance and there's no remoteness to a family member and to our salat al-rahm and to togetherness. If you keep it together and you visit one another, even if they're far away, you're still close because you preserve your family ties. It is no closeness to any family ties. If you separate and you are disobedient, even if you're in the same city, about the difference in nothing base, maybe you'll be in the same house.
حافظوا على هذا الخير. انتبه يا إخوتي في الله. أنا لكم ناصح. أنا لكم نذير. I'm a good advisor to you. I'm warning you. حافظوا على هذا بالمسامحة.
Protect your family ties by forgiving one another. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلام والعافية.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.